Hello folks. Well, I asked the eBay seller who sold this vacuum cleaner to pack it carefully so it doesn't get damaged. I don't normally bother saying that because I feel if a vacuum's damaged in the post, then the seller will have to reimburse. So, although I'll get my money back if this is all smashed up, it's a pretty rare vacuum, and so I don't want it smashed up. It was also quite an expensive vacuum cleaner. Wasn't expensive when it was new in the shops. It was a budget cleaner. But when you see them on eBay, a vacuum cleaner that's pretty rare, well, they go for silly money, don't they? They go for silly money. And this one has gone for silly money, but the good thing is it didn't really cost me anything because I'm currently selling vacuum cleaners at the moment. So basically I sold about four, maybe five, I'm not sure, four or five vacuums I didn't want to pay for this one that I really did want. So, you know, it was a lot of money, yes. And I'm sure a lot of you who've seen this know how much it went for. I've no need to repeat how much this sold for, but it was in fact less than I was going to pay. So I feel like the winner here. Well, here's some tools. We'll lift out the original box, shall we? Which is quite battered. There we go, Hoover Galaxy. Right, I have got one other Galaxy, if you remember. I did manage to get hold of the base model. Hang on, I just throw the box out of the way. I did manage to get hold of the base model of this. But you don't see these on eBay. Hardly at all. So when this one cropped up, I knew it would be popular. And indeed it was. I tried to avoid a bidding war with this. I did put in an offer to the seller. So I offered the seller some money, but the seller declined. Don't put offers on. If you're selling on eBay, if you don't want people to offer you anything and you're not going to accept any offer, just unclick the accept offers doobly when you're listing an item. I never accept offers. So I put an offer in. It was rejected as I thought it might be because there was a lot of interest on this cleaner, according to the seller. But in the end, I ended up paying £15 less than I offered the seller for this. So I was happy. I would have gone, I'm not saying what I would have paid for this, but it's probably, it was more than double what I did pay if the bidding had got that frantic. I was that desperate to get this cleaner. So I hope it's okay. Right, well, here we go. We have two metal. Now the two Galaxy models that I used to own had plastic wands. There were other Galaxies that I never got. I think this is a German version because I think it's got a German instruction book. But in Europe they had many different Galaxy models, much more than we got, and they did get more deluxe models with this. There was also possibly a model with a power head because there is a power head socket on. I don't know if it's on this model, but some models did have a socket for a power head. So anyway, two metal wands. Pretty standard hose. The old trigger grip with the suction relief. You have to keep your finger on it. So this was on the, this was always on budget cleaners, on the Aria. Other cleaners I've got this on. It will fit Hoover Compact. But it's friction fit tools, they're not the pip fitting. Right, well that's not what I was expecting. It looks a bit different. This is a pretty bog standard tool. I thought this would come with a tool that the later Hoover Alpinas came with. But now looking at it, that is one of those bog standard awful tools. This would have come with a contour nozzle in the UK, which I do have a spare contour nozzle, which is better than this nozzle. So yeah, I did see it pictured, but I didn't think it was going to be this very common, very cheaply made nozzle. Never mind. This doesn't belong to this cleaner, I don't think. This does, the cheapened version of the upholstery nozzle. I don't think the litter pickers are missing or have worn down. I just don't think it had them. Sometimes, if there were basic machines, they didn't even have the litter pickers. How much would have that saved Hoover not to put those on? But you know, when you're making thousands of cleaners, I suppose every little helps. There's a dusting brush, pretty good condition. And finally, again, pretty good condition. Quite short and stubbly crevice tool. Right, oh dear, let's have a look. This is a bonus that was pictured. Hoover Cleaner World Window Display Contest. And it shows a Galaxy 1100 SE electronic. I think this is what I've bought. Ooh, look at that, folks. Bit of an extra bonus. Look at that, you see, this is showing we never got that. Now that is a Hoover Vogue top of the line. Now I did have one of those back in the day, but in the UK it did have a remote control, a wired remote control, but it never had the Turbo 300 head, and I'm not sure if it was even an option. So we were pretty hard done by. I've seen quite a few cleaners recently that oh, look at that, that the EU got that, or European countries, we didn't get them. We weren't deemed fit enough to have them, which is a shame. Here's another nozzle that the Galaxies were supplied with, the automatic head. If you remember seeing that, I've shown you that on a previous vacuum I opened, one that I imported from Italy. But that was on some budget cleaners in this country. I do remember buying one from Brand New with the automatic head on. I've got a couple of those anyway. The instruction book, which I believe is all in German. Yes, Staubsauger. Pretty basic, isn't it? Pretty basic cleaner. The instruction book is showing the automatic nozzle, so I'm wondering. I'll have to do some research, see if this cleaner did come with the automatic nozzle, and then the spare automatic nozzle I've got, I will put with this machine for authenticity. Right, so there's that. We do have some imitation bags. Yuck. Fortunately, recently, well, after winning this, somebody was selling 4 packs of 5 genuine bags for the Galaxy, so I bought those. Right, okay, well, it's got bubble wrap as well. There we are. And some newspaper. And nothing else. So obviously I'm keeping the box. Yes, the box also, whoops, my light's flickering there. The box is also showing the automatic nozzle. This is, well, according to the box, this is model SC140. Okay, then let's have a look. I remember the Galaxy was also rebranded Constellation. I think it was yellow. I never saw one in the flesh. I never thought to buy one back in the day. I wish we had a time machine. Now, this is in better condition than the base model I've got, and it's a lot more deluxe. It's got a better filtration system, it's got a higher wattage motor. It's also got electronic speed control, and I'm just going to, fingers crossed. Fan dabby dozy, as they say. It's also got the power takeoff socket. So there may be at some point I'll be able to connect a power nozzle to this. Wouldn't that be fantastic? In fact, I did do that with my base model Galaxy when I owned it from new, the pink one. Because it had the cutout, I purchased all the gubbins I needed direct from Hoover Spares in Bolton. Wired it up and then used a hose from a Compact Total system, and I did have a Galaxy Total system. Foolishly, I sold it to my Auntie Mary, who got through vacuum cleaners like nobody's business, so no, no idea what happened to that. Okay, well, before I go into a bit more depth, I'm going to give this a little bit of a polish because I think it deserves it. Well, here it is. The Hoover Galaxy 1100 SE Electronic Vacuum Cleaner. The Galaxy was launched in the UK, anyway, in 1990. And it was marketed at young people, at fashion conscious younger people who wanted to keep their lovely apartments clean. It wasn't aimed at the old doddery folk who wanted the old softback Hoover Jr. or the traditional cylinder shaped vacuum. This was a major product launch for Hoover back in the day. They did use some components from the compacts and other bits from other cleaners, but obviously the whole shell of this machine was completely new, designed from the ground up. And when I first saw the Galaxy, I did think it's a little bit harking back to the classic, definitely the design icon, classic Hoover Constellation. So with my bright lights, it's a bit hard to see the translucent dome, and eagle-eyed viewers will also be able to see the absolute mess behind the camera. I am photographing and cleaning up some vacuum cleaners to sell on eBay, so that's why behind me is in a bit of a mess. But when this turned up, I thought, well, I better get this open just to make sure there's nothing wrong with it. So let's delve into the Hoover Galaxy and have a closer look at this pretty rare vacuum cleaner. So first of all, we've got the built-in carry handle to lift the machine. At the back, we've got a very nicely shaped pedal here for your automatic cord rewind. And obviously I knew this was a German machine. And as we can see, if I can get it out, dear me. Crikey, that seems to be fused in. I don't like the look of that one. Obviously it's got a German plug on it. Oh, there we are. Never seen one like that before. I've got a nicer one that I'll use for this. Obviously I'm going to keep this. I could cut that off and put a UK plug on, a black one if I wanted to, but I'll keep it authentic and use it with an adapter. So you've got the mains cord, and it's, you know, made in France, these machines, but that's a quality cord. So there you go, pull out the cord. It might struggle. I think the rewinds aren't too bad on these. Let's have a go. Well, of course it's curled up, so it's not going to go back very quickly, but if this wasn't curled up, that's not too bad at all. Now, also on the back is an extra filter, something that the two original Hoover Galaxies that the UK had didn't have. So I've never seen one of these before with a filter like this. So I've got to be careful. Well, I won't remove it at the moment. I daren't snap this because, well, I won't be able to get a new one of those. But that filter will come off. It does, I think, say micro 2000 filter, I think. I'm not sure if I'll be able to get that filter anymore, but I would be able to get a filter to cut if I needed to replace that. Looks fairly clean though. So that's the exhaust filter. Here's the control panel, obviously looking a lot more deluxe than the base model Galaxy I've got in my collection. The base model just has the on-off switch, but with the deluxe model we also have a piston bag check indicator that will fluctuate in use and turn red if there's a blockage, or as the bag fills that will go from green to red. But the most deluxe feature on this Galaxy is here, the electronic speed control, so we can vary the suction power according to our cleaning needs. So to access the dust bag, we just have to pull up here on this rubber bumper gently. Ooh. And here we can see it is translucent. There you go, you can just about see my hand there behind it. I have cleaned this up. This was covered in dust when I opened this initially. So that is the visor of the Hoover Galaxy, and inside here there wasn't a bag fitted, so I've put one in. So here's the dust bag. Not a very tight seal on these. There's a huge gap between this seal and the side of the machine. I expect because of the shape of it, they had trouble getting it to fit. You can see there, but once the hose is in place, it does seal to a fashion, but it's never going to be a really tight seal. I think they did at least two versions of the genuine bag. They did improve it because it was leaking dust rather a lot. I'm not sure what the bags are. I've got these ones. These cost £3.25 from Eastern Electricity back in the day. I think I bought four packs of these from eBay, I think for about £12 or something. So these are these are reusable, not non-reusable. They are reusable and I don't have a bag slide to hand. The imitation bags that came with this machine are sealed, so I can use that for now. But yeah, these are the genuine bags for the Galaxy, and these are the only two official models I remember having. The Galaxy 1000S, S3854, and the Galaxy S3850. That's the one that I've shown you on my channel. And if you're interested, the bag code is H27. So we'll take the bag out. Now this is something else that I've noticed Hoover have changed since the first incarnation of the Galaxy. Now it looks very similar. I do have some spare filters. I've not opened them. I'm not sure if they're this type. For some reason, and I suspect the reason was the filter probably kept falling off, Hoover added an extra tab here at the top. So you can see if I take the filter off, and I've just quickly vacuumed that before showing you it, and that was covered in dust. I could wash that. So the filter used to be just like that. But obviously there's been a modification. Hoover changed it, put an extra little lug on the top of the cleaner. And obviously the motor, you can see, the motor will be stood on its back side. So the fan, I'm assuming the fan is, I think it is, the fan will be uppermost. So it's just, you know, it's stood like that. It's not on its side like you'd find on a conventional cylinder or canister. Much in the same way, actually, as the Hoover Constellation. That was always stood on its end, you know, rather than horizontal. So, there you go. That will need looking at, or, well, certainly replacing. I'll have a look at my stock when I get to them. See if I can find any more online, because if I can, they might be the newer version. But like I said, the two cleaners I had from new never had that addition. So it's, you know, it's a little bit dirty inside. It is a used cleaner, but it's obviously not had a lot of use because there's not very many marks and scratches on this. So in slots the bag, it sort of locks into position. On goes the visor. Hang on, we have to make sure that the bag isn't trapped. What's going on here? Hang on. Oh, there we go. The bag was there. That's it. That's it. There. Underneath, gentle. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 casters, and you can see from the condition of these, this hasn't seen many miles of carpet or floor. Hasn't been dragged around for very long. Still in lovely condition. Let's have a look at the serial number here. So this is Hoover model SC140 052 230 to 240 volts, 1100 watts, 50 hertz. The serial number is 20703901, made in France. I'm not sure how to date this machine from that serial number, but it could well be 1990 or it could be 1991. Now the Galaxies, along with many Hoover suction cleaners such as the Compact and Sensortronics, were made in the Dijon factory in France. Dijon, famous for Dijon mustard. Obviously that factory closed down probably sometime in the 90s when the Hoover factory in Cambuslang, Scotland took over from them. So it was good news for Scotland but bad news for the French workers. And there I do have, I'm not sure if I uploaded it, but I do have in my collection of video clips some reports about that from Newsnight, I think it was. But obviously days were numbered for Canberra slang as well. Okay, let's plug the cleaner in. I have every confidence that this machine will work. Okay folks, here goes. Well, that sounds like a Hoover Compact, so I think that's correct. It sounds okay to me. Let's plug in the hose. There we are. Oh, lovely jubbly. You know, this is only something you'd understand as a collector. It does get the dirt on it quite a lot, actually. Hang on a minute, I can't bear that. I can't bear you seeing the galaxy with dust. It does gather static charge, it's had a good polish, so it is attracting the dust in the air. This is a feeling you'd only understand as a collector. I'm not just talking about collecting vacuums, which is pretty niche, isn't it? But anyone who collects anything, there's always products or items, whatever, in their collection that they really want to have, or sometimes they see something for sale and their heart starts pumping really fast and they start getting that panicky feeling because they see something they really, really want to own, but they're all, you know, they're worried that, oh heck, what if I don't win that, you know, whatever it is. And then you get the disappointment and then you get, ugh. And that's happened to me many, many times. I know it seems to some of you watching, especially the people that don't like me, who, I don't know, why are you watching this if you don't like me? But anyway, I don't win everything I bid on. I've missed out on some cleaners that I've really, really wanted. And I really, really wanted this. And I did put on a very, very ridiculously high bid. But I knew that the vacuum cleaners I was selling at the time would pay for it. So I thought, well, I didn't mind if I got rid of 10 vacuum cleaners to pay for this one. I was happy to do it. I'd rather have one cleaner in my collection that I really, really, really wanted than 10 cleaners that are sort of, well, they're all right, but they don't spark joy, to use Marie Kondo, if you know that lady, decluttering lady. So I am decluttering my collection. I'm thinning out my collection considerably at the moment. But things like this, I'm quite happy to get rid of 10 cleaners to own one Hoover Galaxy. I'm absolutely thrilled with it. I had that feeling when I saw that. I thought, and it was at £300, and I thought, crikey, is that a buy it now? And I couldn't get onto eBay quick enough. I couldn't open the, you know, the seller page quick enough. But unfortunately, £300 was the starting bid. But I would have happily just paid £300. I mean, I probably would have paid, well, I did pay more than that, obviously. But when you're a collector, you just like, there's something about my past in this. I never had this particular model. I mean, it is quite similar to the 1000 model I had, the 1000S. This is a 1000SE, so I assume the 1100SE, so I assume the E is for the electronic. But it is very similar. Little bit disappointed about this nozzle because I really don't think this came with this particular nozzle. Fortunately, because I've got the automatic head, it came in a job lot of spares, so I kept it. So I'm going to put that with this because I don't think this ever came with the Galaxy. Let's turn it on again. Now, I think it'll turn on a maximum. I can't see there being any sort of soft start function. It's going to turn on maximum power. Well folks, because I've never done a suction test on a Hoover Galaxy, I don't think I did one on the, I think it was a 900 watt model, the pink and grey one. We might as well. It's got a clean bag and a fairly clean filter. We'll just see what it measures on the old suction gauge. Well, that's not bad at all. That measured a respectable 90 on the suction gauge. So, you know, pretty powerful for a compact little machine. I'm just imagining this, if I can get the power head working on this, the Turbo 300 power head that I've got. Oh, can you imagine having a little nimble compact vacuum, but with, you know, real oomph, with a motorized power head on it? But at least I've got, you know, I've got the power takeoff socket. I do have somewhere in my collection a Rowenta power head for the Rowenta Powermaster cylinder cleaner. I'll have to have a look at the, it's one of those with the long cord, because this one, obviously, unless you had a power hose, a compact total system power hose, it would be a case of clipping the electrical wire to the hose and the tubes. But I'll have to have a look in my collection at that Rowenta one, because it might have a similar plug. I could take the wire off that and wire it into a Hoover Turbo 300 head. Ooh, that's something for another day, perhaps, when I'm bored, which is very rare. So what I'm going to do, I'll just have a quick push with this rather disappointing nozzle. This is the only disappointment with this cleaner for me. I thought it was going to be the more deluxe one. But as I said, I do have, and if I'll do a bit of research, it shows on the box, the automatic head. So if that is the head that this cleaner was supplied with, I'll take that out of my stores and put it with this. So I've got the full authentic experience, but I've got lovely Hoover contour nozzles, push fit ones that would fit this as well. So let's give it a push. So now that I've shown you the Hoover Galaxy, I can throw it into the garage on top of the huge pile of vacuum cleaners already in there. Well, obviously not. This cleaner is going to be well looked after, cosseted and protected. It will get used again. I will do another video when I've got some space to show it, you know, having a proper clean. But I'm so pleased to have this. It will be well looked after, as all my vacuum cleaners are, even the ones I do have in the garage. Most of them have the original boxes. If they don't have the original box, then at least I put them in another strong box with lots of internal packaging. And I also, in most cases, I wrap the boxes in shrink wrap to keep any possible damp from getting into the cleaner. Because I've been selling quite a lot of vacuum cleaners lately, if you've checked my eBay page. And some I haven't seen for years. It's like discovering them all over again. But when I open the vacuum, it's as good as it was when I put it in the box. Because if you've got a collection of anything, storage is important. If you don't want to find mice have been nibbling at your cloth bag, or constant heat or cold has deteriorated the plastic and made it brittle, you don't want that. So if you spend a lot on a collection of anything, look after it and store it properly. Otherwise, all the money you've spent on your beloved items will be down the drain. So this will be staying inside the house for the foreseeable future. One day, maybe I'll have a nice area where I can display a few of my choice models, a few of my favourites. There you go. Hope I didn't drone on too much. But if you're still here, you obviously enjoyed what I had to say. If you did enjoy it, please give me a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe, click the bell icon, and you'll be notified every time I upload a new floor care video. So until the next time, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you all very soon. Bye for now.